Thank you. my job at the railroad, I decided to go to L.A. for work in shipyards. Eddie Voss says they're hiring welders there.
But can't you get a job here?
I've tried, Lupe. No one will hire me.
Palermo is so young. You need to be here. He needs a father.
I know, but don't worry, okay? When I get work, I'll send for you. They say life is better there, Lupe.
I know, Licia. I know. That's what scares me. What if something happens to you and you don't come back?
Oh, don't worry, okay? Everything's going to work out. I'll take care of everything.
What if you don't come back, okay? What if you don't come back?
Mama, what's wrong?
Ay, hijo, tengo tanta pena. What's going to happen to you when I die?
No hables así, mama. You're not going to die. You're still young. You will live to see your grandchildren.
No, mijo. I've been so sick since your father left. The pain in my stomach and my headaches. And now I'm forgetting things, and with my arthritis, I can no longer clean the houses of the ladies of the country club.
I know it hurts, Mama, but don't worry. The doctor gave you medicine for your arthritis and your aneurysm. We'll get you some for the stomach pains.
No, we have no money for doctors and medicine. And we need to eat, and we owe a lot of money to the grocery room.
I can get work, Mama.
Ay, mijo, you're such a good son.
I'll take care of it. Don't you worry, Mama. I'll take care of everything. Hey, man, I thought I told you to stay out of my barrio.
What, I'm supposed to listen to you or what, huh?
Oh, man. It looks like I'm gonna have to teach you some respect.
Yeah, you? You and who else, buddy?
It's me, man. Huh? You see how you handle knives.
Handle knives? But don't cut yourself, man.
Come on, man, I'm gonna cut you up. Come on.
Please.
Man, you need some start!
Good, I
You know what I'm dealing with here. Am I right?
You don't know who you're dealing with.
Better watch it, Palermo.
Hey,
this don't look like no truce to me, man. Don't worry.
Alas, she mouths.
Ruega por mí, te dejo. Ahora y en la hora de mi muerte.
Begins to fear words that follow
funeral
prayer.
Lo siento mucho.
If I can be of any help,
me acuerdo
cuando
él decidió casarse, lo dejamos. She broke all the hearts of the men in his barrio. She was the most beautiful one of them all. I'm sorry.
I can be of words that drain as they did 10 years before. When his father deserted the family, Los Angeles.
Papa,
sorry.
Manolito. 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 Look, Manolito, look. Look in that window where the light is flickering, Manolito. Can you see Felina's shadow on the window shade?
No.
Can you see the devil's shadow? The horns and tail of Satanás!
Where'd you go?
That's her bedroom. They dance by candlelight. She's a witch.
Oh, es una bruja.
Hay que cuidar el mal ojo.
Evil eye?
Yeah. And don't cut through her yard. Oh. If she sees you, she will chase you and scream porquerias.
Like pee-pee and caca?
Yeah. until your face gets red. And then starts to turn into a devil.
Come on, Felina.
Oh, you come. Oh.
She was alive yesterday afternoon. I saw her and now.
Hail Mary, full of grace. Let's start that one. Wait. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary. Pray for your sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. It's a miracle.
That was the day I saw the candles, the santos, the black book, and the table that looked like an altar for mass in her bedroom. The black book was opened on the altar. It had strange words, not English and not Spanish. One of the letters was as big as almost half the page. And it looked like an S. And it was red and gold. And it looked like a curved snake. With the devil's face at the bottom. Maravito.
What? Melina, you embarrassed me.
Melina. It looks like Santa Claus was looking right at me from the pool.
Dios bendiga, Manuelito.
a storm.
Shall your houseless heads and unfed sons, your loot and windowed raggedness, defend you from seasons such as these? Taken too little care of this. Continue, Solomon. The old king was right. You have taken too little care of this, chingado. You have taken too little care of this. But we don't care. No me importa. Who cares why I became a ragged, a vagabundo? Take care of this!
Thank you.
not so clear today. Then scum on your back. Hercules used you to clean our stables again. Your flower. I read in the papers this morning that air pollution is destroying the cities and environmentalists, they say. It's auto emissions in fireplaces, but they're idiots. All they know how to do is diagnose the problems. They have no solutions, so here's the solution to the pollution. Yes, the pollution solution. Brilliant poetry. So what do we have armies for? And presidents who fight wars we don't want to even be in. And big business just makes lots of money. And they make millions of men, you see, and they send them to the army. And the soldiers take one into all their neighborhoods in front of each house, and they plug them into the houses with those long extension cords. And they come out and hold them up and blow all the pollution away. That way everybody will be happy. Big business makes their millions. The army's busy.
Thank you. Mama,
Mama,
Tomas.
Mama,
Tomas.
Please.
Yeah.
No.
People lie at church. He told a lie, Mama.
What?
Sunday. Yeah, he told everybody that the baby Jesus was born of a virgin. And they all believed him. What about you, Mama?
Go on. Go name your kids. No, Tomas, Tomas,
violence through his bedroom. try to get me. At the moment I'm good and ready.
You don't want him in that place anyway.
Shame in the place, and you shouldn't be there for yourself, Desgraciado.
Hey!
How can I sleep with all this fighting going on?
Well, you said it, not me.
Did you make sure that these pork chops are lean?
Oh, Signora Romero, they've been leaning against the chickens all night long.
Santos, you never change by asking. Oh,
why should I? I liked myself.
Buenos dias, Dios, Father. Santos. Señor Romero, Luis, how are you? It's so good to see you this morning.
Oh, Father, the usual today.
Yes, Santos only today Dublin. My sister is visiting from Denver.
La gordita? Oh, que bueno! Luis, go and get our biggest pork roast, you know, the 10-pounder for the father. Oh, Father, you know, it's too bad she's your sister, ma.
Oh, too bad for whom, Santos? You or me?
Well, take your pick. Father, did you hear about the butcher over at Montgomery Supermarket yet?
No, Santos, what happened?
Oh, Father, it was terrible. You know, he backed into a meat grinder.
Santos, was he hurt?
Oh, no, he just... he just got a little behind in his work, yeah?
God bless the butcher who loses his rump.
Hello, Father. How's parish business today?
The usual, grind.
The usual grind. It's a pleasure to have you.
My next servant.
Yeah, I saw you once. Ah, Mrs. Green, what for you today?
Love a steak.
Oh, a steak. My best. Oh, Mrs. Green, now you're a teacher, are you not?
Yes, correct. Yes.
Let's see how well you know your history. Tell me, how is a steak like a knight in shining armor?
I don't know, Santos.
Oh, Sir Lancelot. Saloy.
What? Yes, Santos, you are so funny. Can I borrow that?
Oh, no, yes, I just ate it up this morning.
Good.
You're welcome, please.
Okay. Yes.
Puffing and chewing on a Phillips Sweetser. The penguin statured butcher at Ben's Grocery Emporium limps as he shuffles from meat block to sales counter.
It's an old football injury, you know, and someday you'll have one of your own.
Oh, yeah, it was my first day as a gopher and stock boy here.
You know, four pitching touchdowns. I scored against that damn bulldog. We didn't even win that damn football game.
Well, Santos, he seldom talks football.
No.
He jokes. He teases.
Really?
He sings. He butchers. Actor, comedian, jazz man. The grocery emporium is his stage. Often, Hurry James accompanies Santos via radio as he screeches on some shoulder ropes. Or wine slices, bologna, and pepperoni. And, ladies and gentlemen, as an encore, shakes a pan full of liver and sings.
I don't wanna. You can have her. She's too fat for me. You know, Luis, I think we'll have jello for dessert, you know? Oh, son of my brother.
All right.
This is... Taguitos. Yeah. Oh, Luis, come here. That's Rufina. Go and ask Rufina what she has in her paper bag.
No, Santos, she'll get mad at me or something.
Oh, no. Oh, she's not dangerous. Go ahead, keep sweeping. I'll ask her myself. Rufina! Rufina, tell me. Que tienes en el paquete, huh?
Que te importa, baboso?
Papa!
Oh, Ben, if you must know, it's my medicine.
Medicino. Tell me, Rufina, is it true that you drank so much Thunderbird that your baby was born an eagle?
It's better than you. When your wife has a baby, it's going to be born an old crow.
Oh,
qué perro! ¡Ay, un gato de mi marido! ¡Muerte!
Oh, it's just my first day here.
First
day? Oh!
Hey, Luis, go and help Rufino with the shoplifting.
No, I remember how Santos, he used to love to help the lovely young ladies. This one day, a pretty young newlywed came in and he told her to buy a pound of chicken grains.
They're on sale, Celestina, and when you get pregnant, you cook them up with some scrambled eggs, and your baby will be smart.
Oh, see, yes. Santos, no.
Just like me. Don't you know? Now, Luis, you know, I see you've taken a fancy to my new man.
So cute.
Yes, yes, sorry. But you know, Luis likes to collect rooster heads. Ooh. Yes. He cuts out their tonsils, fries them up with beans and chili pepin, and he thinks it will help him to sing. The opera! No!
My face turned red like a beet that day, and Santos laughed, and the whole store laughed with him. There was this one morning in particular I remember. Santos came in still fresh, smelling a shaving lotion, and he limped to the radio and turned it on, and then he bowed to his apron and asked to dance to Pennsylvania 65,000.
Don't tempt me. Juices are gonna make you drunk.
That's right. And then you'll have a fat, happy wife you'll have to trim every night on.
No, 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 no.
Ah, it'll never catch me, you know. A wife cannot stand to have a happy man. No, that's why I will never tie the knot.
That's what they all say.
Yeah. Well, I don't mean to change the subject, but you know, the other day, I went to the university to become a doctor.
You have got to be shooting me, man. You went to the university?
They found out I was a butcher. And they kicked me out!
Santos laughed,
but
teenagers.
You know what? It just wasn't the same old laugh that I noticed. It kept taking more and more trips to the traguitos behind the butcher block.
A little nip will make me hit.
This evening, as I was sweeping sawdust from the floor, Santos was trimming fat from fresh cut steaks, and he chuckled as he mentioned something about being a halfback in T-bone formation.
Four pinch touchdowns I score against them damn bulldoggies. I was the halfback in the T-bone formation.
Yeah, he carefully arranged those steaks on a tray, and then he cleaned the butcher block as usual, and then...
You know, the day chicken. I scored their four touchdowns was the last time anybody called me chicken legs.
And he cleaned it, and then he took it and chopped off a wing. Then he held it before his eyes, and he snapped it in two.
Sorry. Oh, Dios. No, you are right to be thinking what you were thinking, Luis. Yes, you know something, Mira. There are no roosters in this pile, and the traguitos that come in this pile are no good for the tonsils. No!
He laughed like his old self, and then he limped to the radio. Harry James waited to accompany him. On stage at Ben's Grocery Emporium.
Chapel, huh?
I don't know.
Give me five, kids.
Santos.
Now we're really dead.
Pretend not to notice your ashen skin peeling away. bearing your heart for sacrifice, bearing the organ that savagely pumps blood through your crippled body. People pretending not to notice that you are crippled or diseased or retarded. Pretending, always pretending. A world full of pretenders, and they believe that they're better than you are somehow because they don't suffer like you do. People pretending not to notice that you are their next sacrificial lamb, their next injured martyr to bear heavy-laden crosses, deceiving themselves into believing that they got off easy somehow. So busy pretending, so intent on hacking away at the cord that binds us all together. They cut that cord if they could, just so they could keep spinning their fairy tales, that they're not connected to the same cord that you are. The same umbilical cord that yokes us all to the same egg. Yet even as they spin their embryonic fantasies, they are spinning through space and time with you, corded to the same womb.
Whatever. The sentiment of compassion. It is compassion. compassion that gives us strength to endure life's pain.
Suffering and disease are psychosomatic. Mind can overcome matter, overcome disease. No, I disagree. Ills are treated by prayer. Praise the Lord.
You are suffering for the sins of your mother. Your great-grandmother. Your great-great-grandmother.
Lucretius taught that all things are the result of a chance deviation of an atom in a rain of atoms. We're the result.
God gambled with Satan.
Look at Joe. The Gilgamesh reads that the gods got drunk and decided to have a contest to see who could make the most miserable human being. We are the result.
No. Here's the formula. 3 hours of suffering is equal to the belief of 300 years in purgatory. If you suffer with that attitude, the right intention, suffering brings wisdom.
That's preposterous. It only brings needless pain.
Oedipus tried to escape his tragedy, and he ended up by poking pins into his eyes just so he could see better.
Too close, disgusting, you know? Jeez, you know, they are
grew up in one great big huge gigantic rubber bin and let them drown themselves in it. You know, if you were to take 100 of their brains and stick it inside a mannequin, they still couldn't get it to sit up straight. Not a bad idea. Make them all mannequins. That way we could just stick them on display somewhere, and then I wouldn't have to worry about feeding them.
And finally, you'll stand up on it, prophesied that your mind would not benefit the reincarnated body of a mannequin. So it became evident to my mind that
these answers were not meant for you.
Crystal beauty of the snowflake and the forms of the skies.